All right, welcome in, Pirate fans. We're here at Taze Valley High School, where the Willisburg Pirates are going to take on Taze Valley in a scrimmage with Jason alongside Jason Smith. Jason, I'm going to text you this roster real quick here so we can get some names for these guys. Willisburg is going to kick off, and there's not going to be a return, obviously, but...
assume that's Braxton Salmons on the kickoff.
I believe so.
Number 80, that's what he was last year.
Yeah, Coach Woodward said that they would have their...
Wheelersburg's in white jerseys, orange numerals, orange helmets, white pants with two black stripes down the side. There's the AD.
Okay. He is in a walking boot. Of course, this will be on Facebook Live, Twitter. They're live streaming, I believe, so we don't know if it's going to be. I don't look like there's going to be audio with this live stream, so you can tune in audio with us as you watch. Taze Valley is a Division II football team. Plays the likes of Circleville, Logan Elm.
Logan Elm, yeah. They won a 7-3 last year. Let's see what Joe Idle has to say about them from last year.
They went 7-3, didn't make the playoffs. But they play a lot of teams in the area, and they don't get very many points from them. So they struggle with points.
Trying to see, find their schedule here.
It was last year.
Yeah. Region. Trying to find what region they're in. Not in 7.
It's Region 8.
Is it?
Yeah. All right, so Boomstick ready to kick it off here. Braxton Salmons at the 40, and of course this won't be returned, but we'll see how far it goes. It goes all the way down to the 6-yard line.
Blown dead. Region what?
8. So we'll have some announcements for you as we go along here. Some ticket information, kind of how the season will go. Talked to Coach Shaw, and he's explaining to me how the governor wants it. And so we'll talk about that when we have some dead ball time. But first of all, Willisburg coming out in defense. It'll be first down and 10 at the 30-yard line. So get some numbers there ready for me.
I am.
Looks like number 54 out there for the Pirates on the defensive line.
That'd be Will Whitley.
Will Whitley, and then 74 beside him
is Taden Adkins.
Hayden Atkins.
He's
a senior.
Yes, senior.
The number 57 out there, I believe that's Holsinger.
Nope, Ethan Eisen.
Ethan Eisen, okay. That's 67.
67?
Or maybe it is 57.
Matthew Nelson?
No, okay, that's 57. Pro eye formation, handle 21, and he's brought down immediately by number 26, I believe that is.
That looks like Carson Williams with the tackle.
That'd be second down and 9, gain of 1.
67's that linebacker. That's Matthew Nelson.
That can't be him. I think that's Holsinger.
Hey, calm down, Mom.
Yeah, she's the only parent that got in
the stadium. She's already mad. Let's see, 4 is that corner. That's Josh Clark.
Josh Clark and Ian Fannin on the corner.
Pitch.
Sweep out here, pitch. Nice run by number 21. LB is what they're calling him. And we talked to the guy coming in. They said their tailback was by committee. So,
new starter at quarterback.
Yeah.
Lowry returning lineman. They're not super big. I mean, they're good size. They got a couple smaller guards. You can hear everything that they're saying.
Yeah.
That would be Mr. Tilly.
I think that's Coach Woodward.
Is that
Mason
Woodward?
Montgomery came too far up on his outside linebacker position. Track play by number 5. Good run, 8 yards, all the way down to the 50.
Mason Montgomery on the tackle, number 24.
Here comes number 43 and number 16 in the game.
43 would be... Levi Myers.
And looks like
number seven.
That's
Kenny Sanderlin.
Yeah.
57 is the other defensive end. That's Ethan Eisen.
Okay. Number 16, I didn't catch his number.
What 16? Hunter Thomas.
Hitch right out to number one. Almost intercepted by Ian Fannin out in the corner.
That is not Ian Fannin.
Number three is Ian Fannin.
That was seven out there.
No, that was number three.
Oh, it was three. Ian Fannin. 23, Eli Swords. So it brings up third down and three. Ball at the 49-yard line of Taze Valley.
Turn, it's a
pass. Run by the quarterback.
Number three's got it, and he's tackled by number four, Josh Clark. Not after he got about 15 yards in the first down. It'll be first down and 10 at the 38-yard line.
We don't have a roster for Taze Valley. Interesting, they've got chairs spread out on the track away from the field for all the players to stay 6 foot apart. Some have masks on, some have helmets. And
Taze Valley is running a pro eye set here. Two receivers to the left. Turn another trap again. Yeah. This time it's
number
met
five.
Pretty well there. But he does pick up 5 yards. Ethan Eisen in on the stop, along with number 24, Mason Montgomery.
Yep.
Levi Myers is coming in for the Pirates now. And he's going to check in for Tayden.
Tayden Adkins, 5'8", 200-pound senior.
So like now you Blake got, Richardson's out there, too.
Yep. And number, look, is that 12? Who's 12?
12's out there.
Matthew
now.
Miller.
Matthew Miller out there.
Yep. Matthew Miller's out there. Good to see him out there.
Twins left. Isolation to the left. That time, Willersburg made penetration, but
54 missed the tackle there. Will Whitley brings up third down one from the Pirate 29-yard line.
That's Coach May over here asking him to watch the ball. We can hear his coaching from here.
Or if he's got his lawn mowing shoes on today.
He probably does. 8 minutes and 30 seconds to go. No score. They're playing it like a regular game for the most part. Turn around. It's
uh-oh,
another trap. It's,
nothing.
This time they stuff it.
Loss of a yard.
Ethan Eisen on the stop. Man, number five's got a sweet mullet for Taze Valley.
Wow. I
mean, that's one of the better ones I've seen.
Yeah. That's long, too.
There's a lot of partying going on in the back in that one.
Brings up fourth down and one.
They're going to go for it, of course.
Yep. Interesting, the center takes the ball back to the huddle with them.
Is that something that...
I think something they're going to do. See, he's got the ball. They mark it with the referee has a...
Wow.
Has like a piece of...
Tape or something. Kind of like you mark your ball in golf.
Yep.
Turn around, another trap.
Oh.
This time it's going to be close. 35 spins and gets the first down. Had him in the backfield and he spun out of it. Got a first down. He's down at the 24-yard line. Shout out to the C store. Shout out to Giovanni. He's Perry's Pizza Barn. I told the Jennings guy. Yeah, you're right. They're spotting it with a piece of tape.
Yep.
And the ball is being taken back to the huddle. Very strange.
Well,
good news is they're playing, Jason.
That's right. Listen, could always be worse. We'd be sitting at home.
That's right. Watching a live feed.
Yeah.
Which I think the guy running the live feed is more in tune in the game than he is the live feed. All right, here we go.
Throw him one pass.
Ooh. Inside counter number 17. That was not going to happen.
Blake Richardson blew that up immediately.
Yep. Be second down and 11. Levi Myers checking back into the game. So
Hunter Thomas goes in.
Number 55 came into the football game. Who's number 55? Trying to catch up on names, guys, this year.
Trying to give it to
Pro I set for Taze Valley.
Cameron Griffey.
Okay.
6'4", 245 senior.
Yeah, there we go.
Pass.
Pass, a flick out. And
no.
Josh Clark all over the receiver, but it was not a very...
That ball was... He went in and the ball went out.
Not a very good thrown ball.
Nope. Third and 11 now from the Pirate 25.
Some good scrimmages in the area. I know Northwest was taking on Portsmouth, I believe.
No, Portsmouth is at West tonight.
Oh, Portsmouth West, that's right. Northwest, I know they had somebody. Maybe it was Colgrove, Fairland.
I wouldn't think OVCs would be scrimmaging each other.
Yeah, you might be right on that. Jackson was at Ironton. That'd be a good scrimmage there.
Yeah, both those teams would be both very talented, yeah. Jackson and Ironton.
So Twins are right here in the third down, a long situation. Lewisburg only have three down linemen. Dime package.
Oh.
Not sending too many. They got a guy way, and that's way too deep.
Nope. He threw it out of the end zone.
Didn't have any good coverage downfield.
Nope.
So let's see if Taze Valley will want to kick one here.
See what kind of kicker they got.
What would that be, like a 40-yarder?
That would
be
42-yard field goal. So it looks like they're just going to go for it, and my guess is they're going to throw it. Somehow three fans for Wheelersburg have snuck into the game on the other side.
At least they're social distancing.
Yes, they're not close to each other. We got some fans in the parking lot.
The tailgating.
Yeah.
All right, so now they have three receivers right. Shotgun. It's going to be a level pass here. And it's caught, but it is.
First down. 12-yard line.
First down.
Yep.
Inexcusable on that one.
Yeah, they won't be happy about that.
No. I want the base defense as Tayden comes back in for the Pirates.
I don't know who was on coverage there.
Josh Clark was in the corner, and Gage Atkins was the
Pirate. Yeah, Gage Atkins. No, the mullet's back in, number five.
Can't beat him, buddy.
Uh-uh.
Let's go, Sammy.
Pitch outside.
Number 21 finds a seam and gets tripped up by Boomstick Ian Fannin.
Yep.
That's not Boomstick. It's
no. Boomstick.
Big Stick.
Big Stick
Fannin.
Yeah.
Yeah. Got a couple of sticks on it.
They got a nice new video scoreboard here. Beautiful complex.
Yes, very nice. Second down and 8 after the run. Ball is just inside the 15-yard line at the 12. Griffey comes in for the Pirates. He's a transfer from somewhere in Canal Winchester or something like that. Like 2 years ago. Isolation goes nowhere. Good defense by the Pirates on that one. It'll be third down and 7.
6 or 7, yeah. Kenny coming out of the game. Kenny Sanderlin. And Hunter Thomas. I believe Hunter Thomas is number 16. He is. He's been playing safety here, in and out. So
Swords is safety.
Fannin, and then you got Mullins at linebacker, Holsinger at linebacker.
Clark at corner. Twins eye.
Right.
Bootleg pass. And
uh-oh.
He's dead to rights if he don't get it.
Uh-oh. The referee just went down.
Almost. And Clark somehow had the receiver behind him.
And the head referee, the white hat, blew out an ACL.
Poor guy.
The guy was running around, and the guy tried to turn too quick and tumbled and fell down. Hat fell off, everything.
Yep. He needs to get them stretches in.
Yep. Brings up fourth down. Here comes the kicking unit. So it would be a... They're at the 10, so a 27-yard field goal for Taze Valley. There will be no rush. They just let them kick it.
Let's go, Cale! Let's go, Cale!
And the field goal is up. And it is away, no rush. Good.
Yes, sir,
and Taze Valley takes a 3-0 commanding lead.
Yes.
All right, so let's talk a little bit about Wheelersburg here, and let's talk about what's going on with the season. And Shaw, if you're listening, this is the athletic director, and these are the directions we're being given. Each student is going to receive.
Each student or each player?
Each player. Well, each player, I'm sorry. Student athlete.
Okay.
Yeah, we're good. We just went on that. We're good. No, you're fine. Thank you.
No problem.
So each player will receive, let's see here, a set of number of tickets. Now, they have not.
They haven't decided.
They haven't decided
right.
How many set of number of tickets. It depends on the capacity of the location.
And if you're home or away.
Right, correct. All fans must social distance. Same also can sit together. Masks are required for all fans, so please do not come to the stadium without a mask.
You will not be
permitted
in. That's
right. Correct. So he wanted to make sure no ticket sales at the gate.
Oh, really?
No ticket sales.
So it'll all be pre.
It'll be all pre-done, and it'll be pretty much families, players and cheerleaders.
And also, I was told the band will not be traveling,
but we'll be able to have tickets.
But at home, yes, they will be allowed.
Performing.
I wonder, will the cheerleaders be on the road?
I don't think so.
No.
I don't think so.
Just football
just
only.
Football, yeah. So here's a kick. And it's picked up by number 12. So Wheelersburg's offense will come out, see what they have. Of course, two kids fighting for the quarterback spot. One is Kenny Sanderlin, number 7, and number 6, Jake Gregg from Ashland. It's Jake Gregg, right?
It is.
Yeah.
And it's not Jake from State Farm.
No, we're going to call him Jake from State of Ashland.
The state of Kentucky.
Yeah. Jake from the state of Kentucky. So it looks like Kenny's going to get the nod today, and Swords number 23 in the backfield.
You got Josh Clark, a receiver. Matthew Miller, a split. And I can't tell who the other wide receiver is.
Here comes the give to Swords up the middle, and he'll pick up 3 or 4. Simple zone read.
That pickup of 3.
Chase Conley is your center, and now we're going quick offense.
13 is the other wide receiver.
That's Case Dyer.
Case Dyer, okay. Mm-hmm.
So second down and a long 6 here. This time Kenny's going to keep it after the fake. He's going to pick up the first down. And get about 2 more passes.
Now we
got
a flag
coming in. Holding against
against Josh Clark. So that would be a spot foul.
Yep. So it'll be basically 2 yards pat where we started, basically. Yeah, that is Ken Griffey's kid. The Griffey kid is Ken Griffey's kid.
Ken Griffey.
Not Ken Griffey Jr., though, just Ken Griffey.
Oh, okay.
He don't have a senior or junior after him.
So now it'll be second down again, and they picked up a yard.
Yeah, that's
from the penalty, because he would have been a first down.
Looks like it didn't even move, yeah, so we're going to replay the down.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah. So Gage Atkins in at the tight end spot, Y spot. Kenny Sandlin, the quarterback. He will drop back to pass. He's got a little float out the cart. Caught at the 39-yard line, and he'll get close to the first down.
Yeah, they make game forward progress there.
I think he was out of bounds before they knew.
No, the chains are trying to go.
Yeah, but
they're like, no.
He spun out of in the bounds. So it'll be third down and 1 at the 39-yard line. Who's number 80 out there for the Fires?
Isn't that?
Swords picks up the first down.
80, isn't that Boomstick?
No. I'm sorry. That's 20.
Huh? Who are you asking about?
That was number 20 going to
Moses. 20 is Gage Atkins.
Okay.
20 Gage.
20 Gage. Gotcha.
Now you got Carson Williams in the backfield.
Two receivers right. Miller goes in motion, and it's a jet sweep to Miller, and he's going to be brought down by the outside linebacker, number 1 for Tays Valley. Lost him 2.
All day, baby, all day.
This guy's excited.
He is.
The Tays Valley Cheer Club. Mossberg 20 gauge.
Mossberg?
That's his 20 gauge.
Tays Valley's a little confused on defense here.
So second down 11. Now we're going to look over here on Brent Eaton, the junior high athletic director. Now he's got a little bit more.
Yeah, he's got a little more knowledge.
More something to say.
Yeah.
So he says we want to play as senior sports are important to us. We all need to do our part. You need to. I do need to. Our family needs to. Our team needs to. Our school needs to. And our community needs to. The game will not be the same without many of you, but we just want to play. For us to have a season, we have to review some safety precautions and guidelines with you. Number one, social distancing has been marked. There will be signs posted throughout the facility. You will enter the facility one way, and there will be two exit points on your way out. Sanitation stations throughout the facility for both home and away. Bring your own as well. There will be markings for select seating arrangements in the bleachers. Our benches will follow social distancing guidelines. Those who need to wear a mask will wear a mask. And even though we don't like it, they're playing. So that's what he has to say.
No good.
He also says if you are a symptom, have symptoms, please do not come.
Right. Keep it simple.
Keep it simple. Soon a video is coming, he said.
So you got, let's try and go over the linemen here. 57, 55, and 51.
I know 55 is Ken Griffey. Twins left. Here comes the motion by Case Dyer. Case Dyer does not. Keep by the quarterback. He's going out to the left. Missed by one of the corners there, and Kenny Sanderlin picks up.
So 57 is Ethan Eisen.
4 yards.
51 is Chase Conley. 55 is Cameron Griffey. Blake Richardson, and I can't tell who the other one is.
Caleb Arthur checking in.
Caleb Arthur, yeah, 32.
Back to pass by Sanderlin. Sanderlin's going to get hit as he throws. And it'll be fourth down and 8 to go.
Yep. Fourth down and 7. Wheelersburg's going to punt.
Again, Chase Collins just taking a football with him.
Yep.
Somebody bringing another football with him. So that looks like some sort of change there.
Yep.
We're going to go back over there and disinfect it, I suppose.
So the new punter this year is...
I think that's Boomstick, too, yeah. And he booms it down to the 21-yard line.
Yep. So that was... about 30-yard punt.
30-yard net.
30-yard net.
Difference.
Yes.
It wasn't a 30-yard punt.
Right. Well, I mean, that was the net.
40-yarder, but it was a net at 30.
Yeah.
So Wisburg come on defense. 3:12 to go here in the first quarter. Taze Valley up 3-0. Exit a light.
No music. It's a lot different.
Tonight.
There are literally
there is
one,
no
two,
emo.
Three, four, five, seven people in the stands.
We brought our headphones and all that, and we thought, well, we don't really need all that.
We can hear just fine.
Yeah. All right, so slot eye left, trap up the middle. Wheelersburg is not fooled on that one.
Nope.
Taden in on there on the stop, along with number 57. Holsinger. Who's number 67?
Well, we have a you said that was Holsinger.
Okay, yeah. 67 is Holsinger. Who's number 57? Is that Eisen?
67, it says a Matthew Nelson on here.
It's not. That's not.
Okay, and 57 is Ethan Eisen.
Okay. Matthew Nelson's a freshman. All right. Okay. Slot eye left, second down and 8. Another roll out here. Here comes the pass, and it is caught again on that left side. That quarterback peppered it over there. First down. This time, Case Dyer is at a cornerback position.
That's interesting. I wonder how that tape will work in this wind or rainstorm.
Unless it's got some sort of weight to it.
Right.
Could be a piece of bubble gum, too.
We don't know. Interesting, they've only thrown the ball to number 1. That's it.
Yep. Rob Wheeler said punt coverage is only counted by net.
No.
But we want to give credit to Harris.
Oh,
almost buried his head, lost his head, caught him in the backfield.
Mason had him in the backfield for a 3-4 yard loss. And
that's what happens when you don't break down.
And guess who's coming out of the game?
They're going to coach him up.
Yep. So bring up second down and 5 from the Taze Valley 37-yard line.
Yep.
The coach for Taze Valley has to reach up and try and yell at the 6'3" wide receiver.
He is a tall dude.
He is. One kid's already gotten mad and taken his shirt off.
Yeah, he just quit.
He's already quit for the day.
Twins eye left. It's a rollout, my number 3.
Right there.
He's got a bomb, and he's got him wide open, number 17. And he's brought down by number 23, Swords, but not until it's all the way down into the 15-yard line. And play action bit. Tatum's going to check out. Levi Myers is going to check out.
Yep. Bringing the big boys back in. They're all the way down to the Wheelersburg 11-yard line. 15-yard line. It's nothing fancy.
Nope.
It's a 2-wide receiver. That's it. 2-wide receiver route.
Yeah. Eaton says we're not social distancing because he can hear us too clear. That's true.
We got masks on.
We do have masks on. They're invisible masks.
That's right.
Shotgun. Twins left. Roll out. Number 3 is going to look. Got a guy deep in the corner. It's way too far. Caught
on the track.
Caught on the track.
Literally 10 yards out of the end zone.
Yeah, he let him a little too far out there.
Yeah.
Well, Taze Valley.
He caught, made a great catch.
He did.
He dove for it on the track to catch it. Yeah, he just said, I didn't know where I was.
What? Willard is watching the stream.
The
He wants to know why there's so much dirt over there.
Well, they're getting ready to build a swimming pool.
Yeah, it's going to be
an outdoor swimming pool.
Yeah.
And maybe parking.
Because there's park near the pool.
Yeah, they're going to park around the pool.
Yeah. Second down and 10. Here's the
counter. Nothing.
This time. The one thing I've noticed is our guys have been there.
Yep.
Their head's been down. Mm-hmm. And they're not breaking down very well, which is coachable. That's a good sign.
Yeah. That was a nice job by Holsinger on that.
Yeah. And that is going to be the end of the first quarter, I believe.
Nope. They blew the whistle.
I don't know why.
Play clock's not working. Preseason jitters.
Yeah. So we're going to run one play.
Yep.
Must have called timeout. Coach Woodward wants an explanation, as he should get it. Puts his mask back up. And that is the end of the quarter. All right. So the first quarter score, Wheelersburg down 3-0. Looking at a third down and 10 at the, was that the?
Yeah, they're at the
14-yard line. Listen, on our way up, we stopped at Raising Cane's. You're a big fan of Raising Cane's. I'm a big fan of Raising Cane's. Does anybody not like Raising Cane's?
Probably not.
All right, we'll be right back. BirdFan.com.
She told me her name was Billie Jean, and she caused a scene. Then heavy hit.
third down and about nine to go.
You got
a pro eye right, and this is probably going to be a bootleg or straight. Uh-oh. Oh, bad snap. Number three can't handle it. Number four is holding way bad out there. And there's the pass interference.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a pass interference all the way. Holding on,
yep.
Clark.
Clark, yep. How, it was obvious.
Yeah, he was holding the whole time.
Yep.
So Clark's struggling a little bit with that wide receiver out there.
He's talented.
Yeah, number 23 can play some football.
Well, yeah, him and the tall kid, where is he at? Number one here. Both of them are very good.
So it'll be automatically.
Oh, no, it's not.
Should be an automatically first
he
down.
He just said third down.
Okay. Still three, so.
So that's not an automatic first down like it is in college and NFL.
So this is not a given that first down for it. That's another 3 yards to go, and Williamsburg's been pretty steady on the inside run defense.
Yeah, it'd be interesting to see what they do here. I think they're going to give it to Mullet.
Could be a Mullet play.
This Mullet play up the middle.
All right, turn down.
There we go.
Isolation, picks up the first down, almost a touchdown, gets down to the 2 yard line. Ron the Barber may be announcing home games this year.
Ron the Barber. What's Radar going to do?
Radar is eight. I don't know what he's going
to
do.
Are we allowed to have a concession stand?
I don't think Radar's allowed in the facility. He's a high risk hamburger thief.
Yeah. So,
Mullet man comes off.
This is going to be three plays of right up the middle.
Right up the gut.
Yep. I mean, I'd be shocked if it was anything but. That's a false start.
Yeah, they 33 that time. He goes all the way down to the half-yard line. Second down. About a half-yard to go to end zone, pay dirt.
So they're not interesting. They still run their plays in and out with the player.
Yeah.
The play clock is either not working or they don't know how to use it. It's one or the other. It spends half the time on zero.
Yeah. Yeah. This won't go down next week.
Nope. Here we go.
Number 70, their guard ain't very big fella.
He's a tiny little fella.
Mm-hmm.
He's a tackle. No, he is a guard.
Slot eye left.
They're unbalanced.
Quarterback does.
Nope.
Put your hands
up! He's down. He did not get there. Yep.
Man,
he's right.
He's
on it.
The official, that has to be the mechanics of the year right there.
Yeah, that's right.
He got three quarters down, didn't touch his knee.
Nope. Well, he's got an ACL tear.
It's true.
I mean, that's on the quarterback. He didn't get the snap, and then he's trying to fumble it, and then he just goes down. He just falls down thinking he's in.
Third down and about a half yard to go. He did not make it in.
Nope.
It was going to be a quarterback sneak.
I think you see two more quarterback sneaks.
Yeah, I mean.
Play clock's still not working. We got three photographers in the end zone, though.
And here it comes.
Uh-oh.
Now, I don't like the play call.
I don't either. Uh-oh,
don't
the quarterback's
like the
hurt.
Call.
He's twisted a knee or an ankle.
And he just toss-sweeped it, too.
Yeah, I don't like that. Like, why do you not just run up the middle?
I don't
you're
like
half
the
yard
call.
Away.
Don't like
and you're under. Oh, my, they're going to kick a field goal.
Well, you got to learn.
It's a scrimmage.
It's a scrimmage. This is exactly what you do in the game.
That's right.
Next Friday, the Williamsburg Pirates will travel to Chillicothe.
Now, Chillicothe has a nice, large stadium, but they probably won't let random fans in the game.
It probably not. I think that the
How will that work, I wonder?
Put a big airport around here.
That one's taking off.
Kick is up, and no good.
No, he missed
it. Pushed it right.
27-yard field goal. I wonder, I mean, because obviously each week will be different.
Well, I think in Wheelersburg's thinking process is there's no way to say, okay, this week we're allowed 20 more fans. I think it's going to be each player is going to get an amount.
They'll probably say, we just divvy it up amongst the players on the road.
Yeah.
And say, here you go.
Here you go. Enjoy. Now, what happens down the road when OHA says, hey?
Hey, when the state playoffs are here, we could put 5,000 in Ed Miller Stadium. Because it's a playoff game and we need the money.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, think that'll change?
Probably.
Yeah.
My guess is they'll probably play neutral sites where they can hold a lot of fans. Maybe like something like this.
Yeah, this is nice. Or Jackson.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, here we go. Wheelersburg's second possession on offense. See who's going to come out quarterback, if it's going to be Sanderlin or Bird.
No, it's Jake from State of Kentucky.
Oh, Jake from State of Kentucky.
Yeah.
It's going to be...
It is going to be...
Sanderlin,
all right. Swords out there with him, too.
Yep, Swords in the backfield. Dyer, one out, one wide receiver. Miller is a receiver in the slot, and I can't see... Arthur is the other one.
All right. So we got two receivers right, one left. Casey Dyer on the left, solo out here. Sanderlin's going to give to Swords up the middle, and he's going to pick up about 1.5. And here comes Lattimore, Derek Lattimore, sophomore running back.
He's a thick
number
kid.
Two. He's
thick, like short.
Yeah, he's built like the bus, Jerome Bettis.
Yeah.
Second
sophomore,
down.
Sophomore, right?
Sophomore, yeah.
Okay. Sanderlin and Lattimore. Is that Derek or Eric?
That's Derek. There comes the motion by, and it is a give to Derek. And he tries to cut it outside, doesn't get anything. That's number 17. Come from the outside linebacker position.
So now you have 3rd and 10.
They're ducking it.
Caleb Arthur
still out there. Case Dyer. Gage Atkins.
Gage is the tight end.
Yep. Here comes the motion. Gonna be a rollout.
Flag. He's gonna get a.
Yeah. That's gonna come back.
Why?
An illegal shift. Too many men in motion.
Yep. Who was moving? Did you see?
One didn't get set. Too many people.
So illegal motion will bring it back to make it 3rd and 16.
And it was a first down. Good pass by Kenny.
Well, yep, nice pass by Sanderlin.
So with 7:30 to go, Wheelersburg's offense has really not done much, have they?
No.
Maybe one first down. So double sticks here.
You got it.
So they're going to go cover two here. Look for Taze Valley. And it's going to be a slip screen to Caleb Arthur. He catches it.
Oh,
and another
flag. So that's
an eligible man downfield. Be fourth down. They'll take the result of the play.
Thought that was a loss of down.
No. They declined the penalty, so.
But what I'm saying is, I thought it was a loss of down. Like, you got the penalty and the loss of down for legal man downfield.
I don't know. Maybe.
But obviously not.
Well, we're going to punt no matter what.
Yeah.
That would be, that's beyond the.
I don't understand why we should be up here. They declined the penalty.
Got an update from Shaw. He said tickets will be distributed to football players for next Friday's game. No traveling band or cheer. So no traveling band or cheer.
Okay.
Got a shout out. Said how bad did Chillicothe smell on the way up?
Not bad at all.
They weren't making much paper. Here comes the punt. And it is a nice high
nice
spiral.
Kick.
Takes a Wheelersburg bounce for about four more yards, and it'll rest at the 24-yard line.
Well, 7:14 to go. Second quarter is still 3-0. The ice cream truck has found its way, but there are no people to buy any ice cream here.
So 3-0. What have you seen so far from the scrimmage? It's hard to tell.
We need another scrimmage.
Yeah. It's hard to tell. I mean, we're not playing bad.
No.
And we are playing a Division II team.
That's right.
So
that went 7-3.
Yeah.
They were good.
This isn't going to be a typical look at what Wheelersburg might face, but
that's good.
I think there's some things that they can clean up.
Sure. But that's why you have scrimmages.
Yeah, that's right. So I got a false start by Taze Valley.
Yep, the little guy. Holsinger.
Number 66, is that Holsinger?
Well, you said 67 was Holsinger.
No, that's his brother. There's two of them.
Oh, there's two
there's
of them?
There's a junior and a senior.
55.
Counter, 55 in there.
Nice tackle.
Look at Holsinger mixing up little Holsinger.
Sorry, I had to call.
That's Griffey, 55. And
that's
66
Griffey.
That's Drew, is Drew Holsinger.
Chad May
hollering.
Sometimes I just think he hollers stuff just to say it.
Well, there's no pickup on that. Still second down 15. Ball at the Pirate 21.
Yeah.
Quarterback's moving around a little bit better.
31 looks like a big, pretty big dude.
Yeah, he does.
There. All right. Pro eye left. Drop back to pass. Number 51, Conley giving chase. Ian Fannin turn. That's pass interference.
Yep.
Ian, you got to turn your head.
Never turned around.
Ian Fannin. Coach is mad at the official because he said face guard is legal.
Face guard's legal.
But he put his hands out. Maybe that's why they're calling it pass interference.
So it looked like a face guard.
But apparently held him?
I don't know. It looked like a face guard to me.
Well, I've never been seen a whole senior and whole dinger is what he said. So we got whole senior. That's the senior, and then Holdinger.
Holdinger's the junior.
He's bringing up the rear. Both are tire boys.
Yep.
Their dad owns the tire shops. All right.
Uh-oh.
Nice turn in. Good tackle.
Good pursuit.
I don't know what happened here, but.
Yeah.
We can hear everything Coach say. It's great.
Yeah. We're tackling the ball carrier.
William said, go tackle the ball carrier.
Yep.
Oh, you're fine.
Oh, you're fine.
Okay, so
Holdinger's coming out. Man Bear Pig's checking back in. He had two burritos while he was over there.
One of those cheesy burritos from Taco Bell, the cheesy, the grilled cheese burrito?
Yeah. 5:42 to go here in the second quarter. Second down and 8.
Ball at the Wheelers or Taze Valley 38-yard line.
Wheelersburg might get a little fired up now. Trapping Man Bear Pig.
Man Bear Pig said no way.
Yeah.
He just fell on him.
I tell you, one of the question marks I had coming into this season was the interior six. They've played really well.
They have so far.
In this scrimmage.
Yep.
And the defensive back positions, I thought were going to be the strong point, and they've kind of struggled. So
a little bit they've struggled.
Yeah.
But it.
Lattimore checks in as a number two. There is an outside defensive end. He'll probably be rushing the quarterback.
Oh, he went his.
And the pass is incomplete. Little high
yep.
for the receiver. And it'll be a punt situation for Taze Valley.
They're trying to find the football.
Well, here's the thing about this. Is this is the first time both these teams have actually played somebody.
Sure.
Yep. And you can't expect coming in here and being crisp.
No, absolutely not.
And both teams have kind of struggled.
Well, both teams have new quarterbacks.
Sure.
That makes a big difference, too, you know.
We'll see if
Matthew Miller is back to receive the punt.
I think he should fair catch it.
He's asking the ref how to fair catch it.
Yeah, I don't think he should run with this one.
Well, you can't run. They blow it dead as soon.
Yeah, I know.
Whoa.
Some girl come from the 80s.
That's right. Smash Mouth.
Smash Mouth. That's 90s, actually. Yeah. All right. Here comes the snap for the punt.
Maybe.
And it is a good one. And it's a low liner. And Matthew comes
good.
Up and fills it up to 29.
Good job. That's a good job.
Kick it away from the guy. I don't want to give it to him.
He kicked it right to him on a line drive. And good job by Matthew Miller to come up and get the ball and not let it bounce 20 yards.
That is true.
He just chucked the Taze Valley ball over to the sideline. Took out two coaches and a headset.
So it'll be first down and 10 at the 30-yard line or 29-yard line. Taze Valley looking for a corner.
He's grabbed someone.
Jake from State of Kentucky in their quarterback.
Yep.
Along with Carson Williams. And it's a fumble. Third down and second down and 12.
Loss after a fumble.
Yeah. I don't know what happened there.
It looked right up his helmet.
Looked like Williams got in front of the snap. Took off too early. Those are timing plays. So.
Yep.
So Twins right for the Pirates. They've pretty much been in the same formation the whole entire time. And he got whipped.
Wow, that kid has been a problem all night.
He has.
Number 31.
Quick off the outside linebacker position.
Is he coming from a linebacker or a DN?
That's 51. He's coming at the DN there.
He is the DN. 51. There he is. So he's going to the strong side.
No, maybe it was 31. You're right, 31. So Jake from the State of Kentucky will be dropping back to pass, and he's going to be chased out, and he's going to be they blew it dead.
We're not sure why.
Well, they're protecting the quarterback. Coach Woodward was saying, shut up.
It's like it's a scrimmage.
Yeah.
Calm down, guys.
Let's calm down. Tilly wants the first down in a scrimmage. He's all there are in competitive spirit.
That's right. So it's third down and.
Well, what happened was is defensive lineman was coming after the quarterback pretty good. He did get the ball off, but as soon as he looked like he was going to hit him, he was protecting the quarterback.
Right.
Probably something that they're going to try to do today. Trips left. Drake Gregg from State Farm is going to run. And
nice
now he
throw.
Throws over the middle. Caught by Clark. Spin, and that's a first down, down to
that's
the
48. That's a nice ball.
Nice ball.
Jake from the State of Kentucky threw a nice pass there.
He did.
He hit him right in the four, right in his chest.
It looked like he could have
ran
for it at first down, too.
That was the best offensive play they've had all night.
Yep.
3:29 to go in the second quarter, still 3-0.
Jake from the State of Kentucky in there with the swords now, the H-back. Case Dyer is going to come in motion. It's going to be given to him. And he cuts it up. Nice run.
Yep. That's two plays in a row.
That's one of those zone stretch plays where you just try to find a seam.
12 yards.
Yep. And this is the best, like you said, this is the best offensive possession had. And it takes a little bit of rhythm.
Sure.
To getting in these.
So you got Arthur at one receiver. You got Hunter Thomas at the wing. Dyer at the slot.
Yep, here comes Case Dyer. This time the quarterback's going to keep. He got eight up, and again,
that's the same
number
kid,
31.
We haven't blocked him yet.
Not yet.
Very well.
No, not very well at all.
Oh,
loss of eight.
The Taze Valley kid picks up the football. They got to call time and desanitize it.
Yeah. They'll probably burn the football later.
Loss of six. It'll be second and 16.
Yeah, number 31's eating our left tackle up a little bit. Here comes the motion. And it is a give to Case Dyer, and he cuts it back up again.
Nice.
Finds the seam. Great job by Case Dyer. And number 51, little shaky, but gets up.
So that good run. Picked up 10 yards, so it's third and six now.
So got a little rhythm here with the Pirates, even though the sack took us back a little bit. It's going to be two down territory, I'm sure. Let's throw out here to Clark. Clark makes one man move, and he may get at the first down.
Man, that was a great job by
Josh
Clark.
Good job.
Great play. Got the ball out quick. Made one man miss. That's all he had to do.
That's it.
And got 7 yards and pick up a first down.
So it'll be first down and 10 at
Clark
the 22.
Throws it, or Clark. Jake from Kentucky. Jake from the state of Kentucky. He throws it well.
Yeah, he's been pretty on point today.
Yep. Here comes a blitz.
And it's a give to number 23, and he is ate up pretty good. That left side of the line for us is having trouble with their right side of the defense.
Yeah. Both those kids are playing well at 31 and that big kid inside, big kid number 57 inside.
Yep.
So see if they'd like to see him throw the ball to Caleb Arthur out here.
Lewisburg has not come out of this same. And then Craig,
what
Jake,
is that?
Number 31 again.
Holy cow.
It don't matter what side that 31's lining up. He's whipping anybody on.
He is beating us silly.
We got a timeout on the field. We'll be right back. Burke fan. Woo.
Let's go.
No masterpiece. Hey. 10 bad, then they after me.
Bad.
1 bad, look like a masterpiece. Looking for a dunk like an athlete. Big drip, what you call it?
Big drip.
Ice chain, peeled water.
Ice.
You got the cab, but can't afford them.
Cash.
You got the bad, but can't afford them.
Give me the beat, I ride it like a jet ski.
Hey.
Some of the bad, they harassing me.
Bad.
They like me cause I rap and be with the athletes. Stop asking me, I know they mad at me.
Nah.
Hop in the coupe, then I slide like it's Vaseline. West Coast 6-4, jump like a trampoline. Take a brick out, put it on the triple beam. I'm not from Canada, but I see a lot of teams. Dismantle her, I know how to handle her. Light the candle up, make you put a banner up. Toss a 50 up, make them tie the club up. Took your bitch out the game, I had to sub up.
Swap.
No masterpiece.
Hey.
10 bad, then they after me.
All right, we're back here at Taze Valley. 1:19 to go. Wheelsburg down 3-0, marching, third down and 14. But we found out why number 31 is winning the battles. He's a senior and been a wrestler for a while, they said. So
not like Whitey wrestling.
No, not Whitey wrestling.
Real wrestling.
He don't put a mask on every time he goes out and wrestles. He may have to now with COVID.
Well, that's true.
All right, swing out. And this was just wasn't a good play.
I'm not sure. Third and 12, and we're just running quarterback around the end.
Yeah, they tried to outflank him there, but couldn't do it. Be a loss of three. So be fourth down. Ball's on the 30-yard line. Got to get to the 14 for a first down. So it's quite a bit. About almost 18 yards there. So they'll go for it. Nothing to lose.
Right. But here again, look at Caleb Arthur at the top.
Yeah.
Going against a little tiny cornerback. Right there.
And it's caught by Clark, and he falls down.
Well.
Got some of the yards back, but not enough. So it'll be first down and 10.
Clark in? Junior?
Junior, yeah.
I'd like to see if old Boomstick could hit a 47-yarder.
Yeah, that's true.
Scrimmage?
Yeah, the score don't matter really on this
stuff. Those teams run
base stuff. Yeah.
But there's not exactly any scouts here.
No.
There's that ice cream truck again. I don't see it though.
Probably over there in the neighborhood.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's an ice cream truck and Jason Smith is jonesing.
40 seconds to go, first half.
Fan complaint asking updated music.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
I almost had him.
Oh.
Oh, I think he got him in the Garden of Good and Evil. Do we have a flag here?
Timeout.
First down. Lattimore got up field so quick, he went past him. He needs to curl that one in. Got a timeout.
Timeout.
30 seconds to go here in the first half.
He got around there quick.
He did. He's going to be in there for third down situations long. Well, let's see if they like this one.
What are they complaining about?
The music. They don't sound like the music.
What's wrong?
Lord, I don't know. How about the final countdown?
We got like four songs.
Yeah. Tell them to send us a check. And we'll pay them. Whatever they want.
Ice cream truck. He's found his way to the field for all five of us.
Yeah. A man bear pigs are going out there with $1.25.
No way.
All right, so it's 30 seconds to go, first down and 10.
That's awesome.
Two receivers right, quarterback in the gun, drops back. He's going to float over.
Nice.
And Gage Atkins just brings him down.
Yep. He got second. Around the back, curled around, and made the tackle.
So they sent. That was the first time they've sent an outside linebacker blitz on that one.
Yep.
So. Okay, 13 seconds.
They got one more play left in the half.
Yeah. Well, they're hurry up offense is not
Clark's
that good.
Limping. Flag.
False start.
So false start on the Taze Valley's Vikings. They called their third and final timeout to set up a 70-yard play.
Yeah.
The end of the first half.
Well, Doug Flutie did it, so
yep.
It can happen.
I like to have that scoreboard. Josh Drake said he'd be willing to pay for some music.
Oh,
so
good.
I'll see if he can get us some money. He'd like to hear Marshmallow.
Marshmallow.
I don't even know who that is.
Yeah, we don't play Marshmallow.
But you're not going to hear Marshmallow on Birdfan. Here we go. Wheelsburg's playing deep safety, so like five of them. Uh-oh. That play went nowhere. That play, he threw a slip screen that went backwards 10 yards.
I think he slip screened as it was supposed to be a slip screen to a quarterback. That's the end of the half of this scrimmage. 3-0. Taze Valley wins
the first half.
They will be on defense in the second half, right? We kicked off, right?
Yes.
All right, we'll be right back, BurkeFan.com, and we'll talk about what we saw. All right, we're back here. We got a 10-minute half. They are going to limit the halves to 10 minutes this year, not 20. something different. So they got to get used to kind of.
And they don't even go in the locker room.
They don't.
So they're going to stay out here.
They're going to stay out here. And it got a little muggy up here. Score is 3-0. So what we saw is Wheelsburg had one good drive in the first half. Got bogged down here a little bit. I haven't seen any other formations from Wheelsburg other than their what they call a snake formation, where they have two receivers right, one left, and a slot that kind of motions in and out.
Joel!
If we don't start playing marshmallow, we're fired.
Come walk down this. You don't have to come up.
I can eat a marshmallow.
Here. Marcus here.
Just looking at the results here, about what I expected.
Yep. A lot of inconsistency, a lot of players playing.
A lot of players playing.
Which is what you want. That's what you're out here for.
One highlight, I think, has been the interior defense.
Yep.
How do you want us to do the seats?
Defensive backs have struggled a little bit, but, again,
just mark them off 6 feet?
If you kind of look, it looks like there's only three out there, so they're kind of on an island out there. Yep. So they're going to have to trust them a little bit.
Those are 18-inch seats.
Okay.
Are we going to have to move for you guys to mark? We're going to get out of here before they put caution tapes on her.
Yeah, we're good right here. Okay.
Taze Valley is walking back into the high school. I don't think they're going to make it by the time they get back.
Oh, my.
Listen, here.
Whoa.
Oh.
No.
Well,
listen,
hang on.
Hey, let's put you on live. Let me put you on. Say that. No one knows who you are.
Well, I better pause it. Be right back.
Burping
right
there.
quarterback, and if you guys have any updates on some scrimmages around that you've seen or looked up online, give us a holler back here. Wheelsburg playing Division II, Taze Valley. Big step up.
There is 4 minutes to go, and they just now made it to the locker room.
Yeah. Yeah, for some reason, the Taze Valley football team walked a good 300 yards to the building.
Yeah.
And they only get 10 minutes, so.
They got in there, and they're going to have to instantly turn around and come back.
Yeah.
I don't get it. The coaches haven't even made it there from the press box.
Man, it just picked up some mugginess or something.
Yep. So, give an update to Rob. All the dirt you see in the background, they are building a brand new indoor field house.
Yeah.
That will house 3 volleyball courts, 2 basketball courts, an indoor track suspended up on the second floor, locker rooms, coaches' offices, and a few other things. So,
all right. So, Coach Woodward shared the updated calendar for us.
Okay.
So let's just take a look at the varsity. Tomorrow is the rib dinner. There is no place to sit down, no meet the team, obviously, this year. But just take your ticket, go pick up your rib dinners, 7:30. Then next week, Wheelersburg, Friday, they don't start school until the Monday after.
No, they start school on the 31st.
Right, the Monday after 28th.
Yeah.
Next Friday.
Yeah.
But that 28th, they'll start their regular season. It will be at Chillicothe, 7 o'clock. They will play 6 games this year. They'll go right into their conference schedule right after that. They'll be home at Memphard and home with Oak Hill. They will travel to Waverly and have Valley at home, then at West. Then after that, playoff, if they choose.
Yeah, it's an option.
It's an option that you don't have to do, but you can do. Everybody will make a playoff spot in the region. Those who want to play, they'll seed them probably after that.
Right.
And then
the other thing is on that, if you choose not to play in the playoffs,
you can continue playing.
You can play regular season games against whoever you want to schedule.
Right, correct.
Up till what, November?
Up to, well, 10 games total.
10 games total.
10 games total. So also, if you would lose in the first round of playoffs,
yeah,
should one of the teams lose in the first round of playoffs, they can continue to schedule 3 more games after that.
Okay.
So they're allowed to have a 10-game season no matter what if they choose, and they can pull it off.
Okay.
So looking at the freshman schedule, it has changed. They will not play until September 3rd. They'll be up at Ironton. September 10th is open right now. They're trying to find a game.
Yeah.
They will have 2 games with Jackson, 2 games with Raceland, and 1 with Ashland. So their schedule got a little bit messed up. And it's hard to schedule freshman games anyhow.
Listen, Brett said something really good the other day at our volleyball meeting. He's like, look, with everything going on, it's going to change day to day. You're just going to have to learn to be flexible because things are going to change from week to week.
It is. And we're hoping, praying that these kids can, everybody in the state of Ohio, can finish a season or have some sort of normal season, because it's not been normal since March.
No. And be thankful, we could be in Columbus or Toledo.
Yeah, in one of those cities.
And those, they're already canceled.
Oh, they suspended. They're not canceled yet. They're suspended.
Now, did I hear correctly, Chesapeake has reinstated?
Reinstated football, but not online school. They're going still online, but they're going to allow them to play football.
What about other sports? Are all sports?
All sports, yeah.
Okay. Well, that's good for the Chesapeake kids.
Yep. The JV schedule's also a little weak. They only have 4 games.
Out of 10.
Well, so home at Chili, at Memphard, home at Ashland, and home at Waverly, and I'm sure Coach Woodward will do his best to pick up him and Coach Shaw. So while there might be a change in schedule and the way it kind of goes, the good news is they're going to play some sort of season.
Hey, like I tell my softball kids, right, enjoy every minute you get out here, because you don't know when it's going to be shut down.
Yeah. And we hope that it won't, and we can do our part as best we can and try to follow some guidelines that's set out there. Nothing's 100% guaranteed, but you know, you can try to do your best to And if you're a guy that don't like to wear a mask, then stay away from people.
Yeah. Don't come to the game.
Don't come to the game. Just stay away.
Right. Don't ruin it for everyone else.
Yeah.
And how you feel, pro-mask or anti-mask, doesn't really matter.
It doesn't matter. Just stay 6 feet away.
Do it for the kids.
So, coaches, it says we'll vote for regional seedings. Is what we've been told.
Yes.
And it's going to feel different to these kids already not having a true fan base out there.
Yep. What they're whistling about.
Well, they got them new electronic whistles, see.
Electronic whistles?
If officials wear a mask, they got an electronic whistle that they can hit with their thumb.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
All right, let's see if we got any scrimmage updates here on the only place you can get them, the prep site.
Well, how will they know they're not allowed at the game?
Well, I mean, they're probably streaming it, probably, maybe.
Right.
West up 7 on Portsmouth 7-0, and they're scrimmage. Portsmouth 7-7. Portsmouth 14-7, halftime. Fort Fry up on Morgan 6-0.
What's the Colonel Crawford score?
Nah, we don't have them. They ain't playing today.
Yeah, they are. They're playing Hopewell Loud and the Chieftains.
Wilson 12, Zane Trace. Portsmouth 21, West 10. 21-17, so no defense. Oak Hill 15, Guy Academy 14. So
yeah.
Looks good there.
We play Oak Hill?
No. Don't play Oak Hill this year.
So it's West, Waverly, Valley, Minford, Chillicothe, and who's the other one?
I don't know. Two scores each currently under a lightning break at Ironton. That is
Jackson and Ironton.
Jackson and Ironton, two scores each on that. Said Ironton, Ironmen are headed up to the tank, banged up on the offensive line.
Well,
but the quarterback, they said, is good for Jackson, which I think we knew that one.
Yes.
Of course, Ironton has Ohio State recruit Reed Carrico back this year, so they'll be a team to have to be hard to handle there. But Wheelersburg does not play them. I mean, that's going to be strange not seeing
playing
that
Ironton
first.
Because
it's almost like the Daytona 500.
Yes.
It's kind of a good kickoff.
Sure is.
Usually those games were close and tight, and I think this year would have been a great game to watch between both teams. And if
we'll see them in the playoffs.
And if chances are, we might see them in the playoffs. Harvest Prep now in the region.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah. So they are Berg's nemesis in sports.
Well, basketball.
In basketball. So not football.
We haven't played them ever in football, have
we? They're a pretty good football team.
Are they?
They're a private school. They can recruit. They're usually
right.
Division 6. They're usually Division 7.
So they moved up because of their competitive balance?
Up. Competitive balance puts them up to
But they've five. Never won a state title that I know of.
I don't think so. I think Marion Local usually puts them out. But
okay.
Now, there is one kid on the Taze Valley team that has the wrong color pants.
Yeah. And he hasn't got in the game because of it.
Well, I think he's in trouble because of it. I think mom washed the wrong pair of pants.
Yeah, he's got the blue ones. They're supposed to be gold pants and blue jerseys.
I'm sure mom is being blamed for that one.
Well, she's not here.
Yeah, so.
So she doesn't know yet, unless she's listening to Bird Band.
She could be, watching the stream.
Yeah. So Wheelersburg is going to receive the kickoff going left to right. So you got refs with masks on part of the time and refs without masks on part of the time.
Well, I think they do put it on whenever they're active. So I tell you what, guys, it's going to be tough. Lattimore and Dyer in the backfield receiving.
But that's not the same Lattimore that was in there.
That's his brother, Eric.
Oh, Eric.
Eric
Lattimore. I'm going to screw that up all year, I have a feeling.
Well, Eric is smaller than Derek in letters, so Eric is smaller than Derek in size.
Ah, okay. That's a good way to remember.
Here comes number 28 to kick off. And it's a boot. And it's caught by number 12.
Matthew Miller.
28. Now, Taze Valley's going to have to find him a kicker. That one
that's
not going to work.
You might as well on time kick it.
That could be a girl, though. Now, that might be a girl kicker. And I believe it is. Small in stature, long hair.
You think?
I think it is.
Okay. Well, good for her if it is.
So she might be doing...
Just trying to get some reps in.
Yep.
Nothing wrong with that.
Nothing wrong with that.
Nope. Here we go. Wheelsburg on offense.
Looks like Jake from the state of Kentucky will come out. Yep. He has two guys, Swords and Williams, in the backfield. Clark and Case Dyer in the backfield. And it's a give to Swords, and he'll pick up
good.
4 yards.
4 yards. Good pickup.
Got a little more power here in the second half starting out. Be second down and 6.
Williamsburg wanting to get in a hurry up.
Yeah, Gage Atkins there.
Gage is confused on what side to go. It's left and right, left and right. Here we go. Finally sails on the right side.
And it is a keep by Jake from the state of Kentucky. And
he does not like to be hit.
He's going to lose there.
Jake from the
Guess who's on the tackle there? Number 31.
Yeah.
And it'll be third down and 9 after the loss.
Loss of 3.
Yep. So again, split backs for Jake from the state of Kentucky. And it's a give to Swords. He'll keep it on the outside. Can he get the first down?
Nice
good
block.
Outside block by Case Dyer. Picks up the first down and more. He'll be down to the 40-yard line, and the coaches are madder than they've ever been.
Yeah, well, he bent him backwards. About not happy about the bending in his back and his knees. That's more of a...
Number 31 is Justin Halls, he said. I don't know if that's Justin Halls. All right, so back up on the four. Split backs. Ah, kid, we went to school with.
Oh.
Hand off right up the middle. It's
Williams. Oh.
He just runs over the cornerback.
And talking to let him know about it.
And we got a timeout.
Oh, that's Mullet. Mullet's hurt.
Somebody's madder than they ever been.
I don't know who that was. Who's the yelling?
I don't know, but he's not happy.
Is it McFadden?
No, McFadden. I think that could be a. That's a. That's a.
That's Coach Kasky, isn't it?
No, that's Coach. We were talking about his son coming up here. Sires. Sires.
Dusty?
Dusty, yeah.
Oh, okay.
He's bringing the Franklin Furnace back out.
Bringing back the green bobcat in him.
He was meowing him.
Well, the good news is the mullet, number 5, is not hurt. He has cramps. So that's good. We don't want to see anybody get hurt on the screen.
No, but this guy right down here got an ice on his shoulder.
Well, he went out like what,
he went
second
first play,
play
yeah.
third play of the
tore
game.
It up real quick.
I mean, yeah, he got a great run and then boom, got lowered the shoulder and he come walking off and sideways and that was the end of his night.
So it's 10:38, Wheelersburg. Down 3-0, driving here at the 49-yard line. Got the ball back here first of the second half.
A little more urgency, seems like, in the second half here. Glad to see he's probably done for the night. He's going to need an IV or some bananas or pickle juice. Maybe they figured out how to block 31. That would be, you know. So Wheelersburg's got the ball. Second down and 6 from their own 49. 10:38 to go, third quarter.
All right. So the split back formation that they come out here in the first has been what they've been going with so far, this formation. It's kind of basically a pro set. And it's a double cadence, and Swords bounces out to the right.
That's a,
another.
I think it's a face mask or.
No, it's a hold on the backside.
You think? I thought I saw a face mask. We'll see if you're right or I'm right.
I don't know. What we got here?
Well, we don't know.
Well, you might be right on this one. Yeah.
Incidental face mask.
Good call.
Thank you.
You saw that one from all the way up here. I'm impressed. You're about as good as Eddie. Eddie Deemer would have never caught that.
No.
He would have been on the field.
No. Eddie's still looking for the ice cream truck.
Yeah.
So. Lattimore back in there for the Pirates, number two. Split backs again. And it is a give to Lattimore, and he cuts it.
Oh,
his
there's
face
a face mask. Listen, none of the refs missed that one.
No.
There's four flags out there.
Again, Lattimore trying to cut it outside, and he needs to stay in his holes. He went straight to the outside.
Taze Valley didn't have a penalty the first half, I don't think.
No.
Well,
no,
the
no,
very
no.
end, they had a false start. They've already had three in the in the this drive.
What I've noticed here, if we were playing this team, is we would not run to the outside on these guys. We'd be running inside.
Yes.
We've not
their
got to the outside.
Their strength are their DNs.
The DNs are very good.
And 31 are the best two defensive players out there.
Yeah.
They've been good all game.
Split backs again. And there comes Lattimore up. And there he goes.
There he goes.
Touchdown, Lattimore.
Touchdown.
The bus.
The bus.
And we
got another cramp.
It has been hot and humid out here, but the bus just went 27 yards for a touchdown.
Yeah. He ran over one, stiff-armed another, and he was done. No one could touch him. Good blocking by the O-line, though.
Yes, good blocking.
I mean, he had a nice hole to run through. They're happy for him. It's good to see that.
Yeah. He's just such a talent. He's going to be a good one for the Williamsburg Pirates. So 9:57 to go, 6-3. Extra point coming, a boomstick coming out. Again, where was that run?
Inside.
Inside.
Yeah.
And that's how we would have to play these guys. We'd have to run it up inside.
Yep. Inside those ends.
And when coaches see this, they just go for what they can do.
Sure.
And
they're just trying to work on plays no matter what the alignment is. And listen, Taze Valley's playing base defense also. They're not showing anything. You know, so it is what it is, and that's
so
okay.
Do you think we go for a fake extra point? I would.
And no, we're going to let Boomstick kick it.
Talk about catching them off guard on this one.
That's true. If we want to surprise the unrushing Taze Valley field goal unit team.
Yeah.
So you got Hunter Thomas, Dorr, and Sammons.
And Boomstick kicks it over the soccer nets.
Yep.
And past the number 8 lane in the track, and it goes all the way to the fence. So Williamsburg takes a 7-3 lead with 9:57 to go here in the third quarter. And I would imagine the first three quarters will be varsity. The last quarter will be JV, maybe?
I don't know, because you only have one scrimmage.
Listen,
they got to get in shape.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, you're playing next Friday. So, I mean, I don't know if it's really time for the JV.
Could be. Well, they only get 4 games, so you might want to get them one in there.
I know, but this listen. You
I
just,
tell you.
And you, listen, if I'm – maybe I'm wrong, but you want to play these kids as much as you can because you don't know when it's going to end.
Yeah, the senior. You're right. You're right. No, you're right. I get you. That makes sense.
And listen, the JV kids, their turn will come.
That's right.
I don't know. We'll see what happens.
Onside kick here? I think it's time. You know, if Jonathan Eaton was out there, he'd be throwing an onside kick in the scrimmage.
Listen, or a pooch.
Or a pooch kick, yeah.
Over to the 30 there. So, let's see. Five is not – Mullet has not made it back out there.
Ball's at the 40-yard line, and here comes Braxton Boomstick Sammons. He's going to kick it high. Not so deep this time.
Nope.
Caught up to
13-yard line. 13.
Yeah. Ball rest at the 30-yard line as defense comes back out. I got some new players out there. Number 61 out there. Got some new guys out there mixing it up.
So they are mixing it up.
Yep.
They want to know who the bus is.
The bus is Lattimore.
Derek or Eric?
Derek.
All right, let's see here.
Number 61.
61 is Jordan Blackburn.
Okay. Jordan Blackburn in there.
Tayden Adkins is in there. don't know who nine is. Brock Brumfield is
Brock Brumfield. Throw out there and nicely defended
nice
out there.
Nice defense by...
looks like Rosberg 20 gauge.
Gauge.
Yep. Number 31. Gauge. Number 31 out there. Who's number 31? Get his shout out.
31
there.
Is Cole Frazier.
Cole Frazier.
61.
Down goes Frazier.
Down goes Frazier. Oh, 61 is Joe Blackburn.
Yep.
Sanderlin's out there.
Number 9 is, I believe, Brumfield.
It is Brock Brumfield. 19, of course, is Dorr, Casey Dorr.
Okay.
24 is Mason Montgomery.
Yeah.
13 is Kason Dyer.
So they got most of some mix-ups.
I can't
there.
Tell who the down 74.
That's Tate. No. Yep. And another run up the middle by Tays Valley picks up 4. So it'll be
61.
Third down 6.
Jordan Blackburn. So we're getting a few kids in there. It's third down.
9:33 to go here in the third quarter. Tays Valley's sending some guys in as well. So it'll be slot eye right for Tays Valley here. Quarterback's a pretty good one.
Yeah, he's done a good job.
They said that when we came in, that he was one of their best athletes. Uh-oh. Play action pass.
Somebody in the flat. There he is. Oh.
Oh, boy. Well, if you're going to
interfere,
that's the way to do it.
That's the way to do it. Yeah, you just tackle the kid.
Yeah, and it's a spot. It's not a spot foul like in the NFL. So. I've got to believe that number 23 for Tays Valley has got some wheels.
Yeah, he's been good. He's been open.
I mean, he looks like a specimen.
Yep. He looks like your good high school wide receiver. Yeah. Probably about.
But here's the thing. It's third down and 6. That's a tough, tough position for a cornerback because you're thinking stick route. You're not thinking deep route.
Sure. You're right. Good call.
And so he probably bit a little bit on a move.
Yep.
But he did recover well. And
he didn't turn his head around.
That's all right. And they didn't score a touchdown though.
Nope.
Willenberg 7. Tays Valley 3. Slot eye left here for Tays Valley Vikings, and they'll turn isolation left and hit once by number 66, Holdinger. Slowed him up just a little bit enough for the linebacker to get to him. They clean him up. Second down and 7, ball at the 48-yard line.
8:47 to go, Wheelersburg 7, Tays Valley 3. Tays Valley is not the quickest team getting plays in.
No, they do not care.
No. And the play clock is not working. Well, we need Jim Fannin here because to be on top of this.
Absolutely. So pro eye left here for Tays Valley. Tied into the wide side of the field. Another isolation playoff tackle. Nice. That time, great blocking by Tays Valley.
By Tays, yeah.
Yep, kind of sealed the inside, block down, kick out. Old-fashioned football there.
Yep. And there was no linebacker to fill that hole.
Yeah, caught up in it. Yep. All.
So it brings up, it'll be first down Wheelersburg, or first down Tays Valley at the Wheelersburg 40-yard line.
That is correct.
7:58 to go, third quarter. The kicker is, he's trying to keep up with Braxton.
Yeah. Both wearing out the
400
nets.
400 footballs a game.
All right, pro eye right. Here is the snap. Fumble on the ball. And who picks it up? Wheelersburg has it. And that quarterback
that's like the third time that's happened.
Been rough a couple times there. And it looks like quarterback is trying to peel out a little earlier. And they throw it over, and there's the ball.
Almost. The mask.
The mask. 58 was the center there. He's not happy with himself on that exchange. No. But the quarterback looked like he had pulled out three times earlier.
I was going to say, I'm going to put that on the quarterback, not the center there. So Wheelersburg will take over, first and 10 at their own 40-yard line. 7:35 to go, third quarter. We'll see who comes out, if it's Kenny or Jake from the state of Kentucky.
Yeah. This time it is
Kenny
coming out here. So
So you got Matthew Miller split left and Clark. Josh Clark split right. Split Gage backs.
Man, good little run by Swords.
Yep.
Yeah, well, I mean, like,
okay, we're not going to let you do it a second time.
Yeah, well, it's easy to understand what Wheelersburg's trying to do. They're just trying to play power football. It's in the gun, but it's basically what Taze Valley was doing. They just threw it out of the eye.
Yep. No huddle for
Kenny, second down and 8. Split backs. It's a keep by the quarterback. He'll keep it up the middle, and he'll get
about 4 yards.
That's about all it was, yeah.
So it'll be 3rd and 5 from the 50 or 45-yard line.
Yeah, 3rd down and 5. 7-3, 6:53 to go.
Here's another thing. I wonder if they'll do any handshakes after the game.
No. No handshakes? It will not happen.
Okay. Yeah.
Unfortunate, but it will not happen.
We can hear Dusty.
Dusty, man, he was louder than he's ever been earlier.
I've never heard him yell.
In same formation, Gage shifts to the right. Running this set. Pass. Kenny's got a wide open guy. Now it curls in, and it's...
That's all Matthew could do.
That's all he could do.
That ball's got to have some zip on it, and he just sort of lofted it down there, and it gave the time to the DB to catch up to him. And
you got to trust your receiver there to get it.
Yeah, so. Throw it up to Matthew and let him go get it. Go snake right.
I think it means snake right. Go snake right.
Gotcha. The shirtless wonder on the Taze Valley guy is still out there.
He just keeps walking around like he owns the place.
Yeah, with a mask.
Yeah.
Right. No, and the quarterback just threw it through the receiver's hands 4 yards away from him.
Boomstick here to kick it away. Good punt. Wow, nice. What a punt.
Boy, he smoked that one. Wow.
And all the way down to the 6-yard line. Buries him deep.
15, 25, 35, 40. That was a 50-yard net punt.
Yeah, he's going to do that from the corner, too, or the goal from the corner kick for the East End. He has decided to play soccer.
Okay. Yeah. They can do that?
They can. It's been done before, and I think Braxton wanted to go back to his roots there and play a little soccer.
Okay. Is he a senior? Is Boomstick a senior or junior?
Boomstick is a junior.
Okay. And the backup kicker would be what? Would that be Connor then, I'd assume?
Yeah.
Connor Estep?
Yeah, freshman.
Okay, so here we go. Oh, Taze Valley's got some new kids in. Well, new quarterback and a new running back. They're going to have a 1st and 10 at the 7-yard line of their own.
It's pro-eye right this time. 4-man defensive line.
Uh-oh. Oh, missed he the had tackle. Him. Was that Holsinger Jr.?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Holsinger, Holdinger has a... He doesn't have really long alligator arms.
No.
He's got alligator arms.
He has alligator arms.
Yeah. He doesn't have long alligator arms.
No, because he had him for about a 3-yard loss.
And he couldn't wrap him up.
Couldn't wrap him up, and he ended up with a 5-yard gain.
Whole senior went out with a knee. He got a stretch. Got to stretch his hammy.
Yeah. He's down. The trainer's out there.
5:42 to go. 2nd down and 5 for the Taze Valley Vikings.
Oh, lights just came on.
That's the night that the lights came on in Taze Valley. Twins eye left, turn, isolation off the tackle. That time they blew that one up.
That time, like, no.
Yeah. In on the tackle there is a host of Pirates, number 66, number 26, and number 72, Man Bear Pig. It'd be 3rd down and 4 after a gain of 1.
Well, now the other kicker for Taze Valley, she's going to kick the ball into the net 40 times.
It's true. 4:52 to go here in the third quarter. Wheelersburg up 7-3 here in this. Pretty much has been a game-like scrimmage. There was other than the kicking.
Yep. Oh, we got a kid out here with green gloves. He looks like the Hornet.
He does. He could be the Hornet.
We're
going
to play
eye left.
Press coverage.
Yeah. We are going after it, and it's going to be Man Bear Pig.
That was a nice play by Man Bear Pig.
Yeah, he just whipped his guy.
Yeah, he sure did. Yep, the Hornet had nowhere to go.
They were just going for a throw deep down.
What is it?
And one of our players from Tate Valley was cussing.
Yeah.
Different.
Well, like you said, we can hear everything they say just about out there. Yeah, it's different for these kids. They're not used to looking for that orange marker per se. So 3:42 to go. Third quarter, Wheelersburg still up 7-3. Taze Valley punting from their own 7-yard line.
Mm-hmm. This could be a fake.
Yeah. Swords back there to snap it.
And here is the punt, and it's...
There you go.
Swords grabs it at the 35-yard line.
So a 30-yard punt, net.
Not good.
Best they got.
The best they got.
That's all you could say. Wheelersburg will take over. First and 10 at their own 35. 3:21 to go.
So, Wheelersburg's done pretty well in the second half, defensively and offensively. Again, we're just not passing the ball well, and we may not end up being that well at passing. We may be a run first, pass second.
Sure.
See what the coaches need to do to adjust to that. Jake from the state of Kentucky comes back out.
Yep, you got Matthew Miller in the slot, and Josh Clark split out wide, and Case Dyer, top of your screen.
And it's a give up the middle. Great block by number 76, if you want to get him on there. 57. Got some new linemen in there.
Let's see here. What number?
Well, I don't know.
76?
I think so, yeah.
Caleb Miller.
There you go. Jake Craig with a long pass down to Miller.
Oh, touchdown!
And he was interfered with.
Let you know about.
He was interfered with the entire
Here we go. Here goes the – I thought for sure they're going to throw a flag. That was a great pass by Jake from State Farm. Threw it up to Miller down the seam.
Yep.
35-yard touchdown
Matthew
pass.
Miller with a touchdown pass receiving from Jake from the state of Kentucky. And 14 almost here as Braxton will come on attack on the extra point. 2:52 to go here in the third quarter.
That was a good pass.
It was right on the money. And like you said, Kenny's got to, if he wants to compete for this job, he's going to have to put some more zip on it.
Yep. That was a beautiful pass.
Yep. Kenny's a tough competitor,
Loon
though.
Stick. He'll, over and soccer good. Goals. Oh, now flag.
And we got a.
What'd they do? Nobody moved.
I got a mouth, a little mouth, and a little cussing.
Take nine out. The Green Hornet for the number nine, the Green Hornet. Run his mouth. He's a smallest guy out there.
Well, they usually do. The smallest guy always is.
That's true.
Got this. Strongest bite.
Yeah, that's right. So, two players got into it. The Green Hornet from Wellston.
Well, there was probably a curse word from one player and then a retaliating curse word from the other. Now, we don't know who won that battle, but we know both of them were penalized.
Yes.
I just hope no mothers were involved in this one.
Well, they banged to their way to the track.
Yeah.
14-3 Pirates. 2:52 to go, third quarter.
Somebody play. Can anybody play? Taze Valley just don't like they want to play.
Well... not the most organized.
No, they need a little help on that one. But
you got the shirtless wonder down here. He's out. Then you got the mullet number five's out.
Number five.
So you're probably trying
he's
to find,
out?
Well, the mullet was in there, but he's cramped again.
He needs to be in there. He's a good-sized kid.
He is. So Wheelersburg will kick it off.
Yeah.
We've only seen the boomstick kick. So if Carson is here, you know, we haven't seen him kick. I don't know. Only 60-player limit this year for teams, home or away. The boomstick kicks it deep and all the way down to the Green Hornet at the 3 or 4 yard line. That was a nice kick by the boomstick. Green Hornet's still trying to find out who to throw the ball to. So we're going to see what quarterback's coming in.
I'll be doing some JV in here.
Well, no. Number 16's coming back in.
He wasn't the original quarterback.
No, that was number 3.
X. Number 2, X. They want X at X.
Yep.
Number 43, Levi Myers in there for the Pirates. So number 27, Glover in there for the Pirates. So they're mixing in some older and newer
Who's
guys.
31?
31 for them or
Williamsburg. We don't know any of those.
I don't have a 31 out there.
Top of your screen, DN.
Oh, that's Frazier.
Yep, Cole Frazier.
Down goes Frazier.
Yep.
Turn and give to the first man. Oh, missed by number 43, Myers. He
Myers
got too far
had
up.
Him.
We're starting for Tayden coming out. Number 32, Caleb Arthur coming into the ball game too.
Then they rotate a lot of boys. You know, a lot of kids have gotten to play. So the quarterback was like, hey, guys, just block this time. I don't want to get ate up by man, bear, pig. So we got a few second team kids, some first team.
Yeah, it's a mixture bag, both players.
Both ways.
Both ways, yeah, kind of seeing two play action here. Again, number 16 rolls out for them, and he's got a dart here, and it's caught.
Yep. That was a nice job.
Was by number 7 on the comeback route.
Comeback route and hit him right in the 7. Brings up 3rd and 1 from the Taze Valley 39.
Yep, 1:55 to go here in the third quarter. I couldn't see who the cornerback was over there. I think that was Ian Fannin.
Ian Fannin.
On the coverage.
Yep. Here comes the big receiver number 1. See how they still got the pro eye.
Yeah, this is a slot eye here. The slot in the backfield. So it's going to be a trap here. Nice cut. Oh, nice job.
It.
He did not make it. Number 27, Ethan Glover. In on the stop. It'll be 4th down and 1. They gave him a little bit more than what I thought they would.
Yeah, that's a generous spot. Yeah. Coach Tilly was not happy about that spot.
There's a replay on that one, boys.
Who's 27?
27 is Ethan Glover.
Is he a senior?
Sophomore.
Does he have a brother?
He did. Dagan.
Dagan, did Dagan graduate?
Dagan did not graduate. Oh, Dagan hurt his back, and I think he's out for the year.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So we're going to go cover 0 here, man up. See if defense can hold here for the 4th down, and it's a turn and pitch and a fumble. He didn't want any part of that one.
No. Here again. They did it again.
Fourth down and less than a yard.
Toss sweep.
Yeah.
Just run it up the middle.
Yeah, Lord, I can go out there and probably run it up the middle for half a yard. Don't you think you could get a half?
I think I could.
What is that, like 1 foot and 1.5 feet?
Yeah.
18 inches is all you got. The ball's, 10 inches. All I got to go 8 inches to get there.
Yeah. Now, is Jackson here tonight?
Jackson, freshmen are not here.
No freshmen. Except maybe Easton. Because he's a backup kicker.
Maybe Easton. I don't think he'll be here either.
Gotcha.
Now, he may be for varsity.
Sure.
I don't know if he'll even do that.
Gotcha. Okay.
Easton's got a good leg, but he's young. He's not got the power yet.
Well, okay, but who kicks if Boomstick goes down?
Here comes the handoff to Derek. And Derek's
ran out of room.
Yeah, he ran out of room there.
He went wide and never cut it up. Sometimes you just have to lower your shoulder
and go up
and get what you can.
But again, we went to the outside, and that's not been there all night.
Nope.
So here we go.
So we got Jake from State Farm. Oh, Jake,
oh, Jake
from State
it.
Of Kentucky got State lit of, up. He should have thrown it.
He should have thrown it.
That's the end of the third quarter.
Quarter, boys. All right, we'll be right back. Birdfan.com. And try to find something they like. I don't know.
We're broken people now. We're burning now. So cold and bleeding now, now, now. Gonna let you down. We're broken people. I won't ever be nothing, ain't that something? I've risen from the bottom, I got them eyes on the prize, and inside them, damn right I overcame. Y'all know the name, we similar but never been the same. Everybody, yeah, they know the name. Right now, I'ma make it somehow, make it some way.
All right, we're back here. Willisburg up 14-3, 12 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter, the start of it. Just saw Coach Woodward come out, talk to the other coach. They're going to go with some subs now, put some ones with some subs on there.
They still got their DNs out there.
Yeah, they're, I mean, well, he said ones with their subs. So right. They're going to start, looks like they're going to start adding some guys in that perhaps haven't played yet.
Wheelersburg got most of their ones in. It's third down and 11 from the Taze Valley 39.
Jake from the state of Kentucky will
zip. Oh, oh boy.
And he's
what
got a guy.
Pass.
And
he
did he catch it? He caught
it. He caught it.
Oh, who was that catching
who
that
caught
ball?
It? That's Josh Clark.
Josh Clark Kent. Superman.
Yeah, he went right over the DB and
wow.
caught it.
Superman just got one down at the one.
But that was a beautiful ball, though.
It was.
it
was a rope.
He threw it about 30 yards in the air. 40
very
almost.
High.
It was at the 39. He threw it to the goal line.
Jake from the state of Kentucky will hand off to Williams, and he will get stood up, and he won't make it.
Here we go. Hurry up. Second and goal from the one.
They're going to bring in the beefcakes.
Well, I don't know. They just brought in.
They brought some other guys in.
Who they got? Who's that coming in? Oh, that's Carson Williams.
Carson Williams. All right.
Carson Williams comes in for swords.
Okay.
So.
A little more toughness up the middle, maybe. Jake from the state of Kentucky keeps it. Touchdown.
Jake from the state of Kentucky with the touchdown. He did avoid contact.
Yeah, that's, some people like don't that's like it.
Listen, you throw a ball like that.
Boy, I would avoid it too.
I'd avoid it too.
Man, he threw a rope.
You sure did.
Wow. So that makes it 20-3. 11-10 to go here.
So we got field goal. Hunter Thomas, the snapper. Casey Dorr, the holder, and the boomstick kicking.
Yep. 11-10 to go here. Kick is up, and it is good. We'll be right back. Birdfan.com.
Now, I'ma make it somehow, make it some way. Yeah, you know we gon' get it today. Like, I'm all on my own now. I won't ever let you down, won't let you down. Down, down. Yes, I've been through it. They know I do it for the people I'm fighting, so we be equal for my son and my sequel. And anybody who listening in they system like venom, I get in them and spread viciously. This is me.
We're broken people now. We're burning now. So cold I'm bleeding now, now, now. Gonna let you.
Young Logic, the rap addict, giving it every part of myself on the real. You would think I'd be asthmatic, allergic to your bullshit. Yeah, that's right, I done had it. Real all the time, if you rep it, get it tatted right now. It's right here, a vibe right now. I am too alive right now, I'm alive right now. Come
Come on, feel the vibe right now. Feel the vibe, feel the vibe, feel the feel the vibe. Yes, I've been through it, they know I do it for the people I'm fighting, so we be equal for my son and my sequel. And anybody who listening in they system like venom, I get in them and spread viciously. This is me.
We're broken people now.
All right, we got an unsportsmanlike penalty against the Pirates. Excessive celebration. I mean, they were really excessively celebrating.
Yes, that's what you want
to
call it.
21-3, 11-10 to go. 25-yard line is where the ball rests, and Braxton will kick it 10 yards away, and he boots it down and picked up by number 21 at the 20, but it'll come out to the 30.
Good kick by Boomstick.
We'll see how many new faces we see. It looks like Eric Lattimore come in for the Pirates. We'll probably go to a lot of JV here. Let's try to get some. Maybe we'll pull up that thing so we can get some numbers for these guys. JV looks like they're going to come out.
We got Caleb Arthur in there.
Number 35's out there for the Pirates.
That would be Xavier Stanley.
Xavier Stanley out there. Glover out there. Eric Lattimore, number one. That's Wilson.
17. Brady Drake.
Brady Drake, sophomore.
Lattimore, sophomore.
Number
one.
That's Wilson.
Braden Wilson.
Senior. I think he came out and played football the first time. He's been out for a while.
Okay. But,
58.
Evan Bricky.
Evan Bricky.
Is he from the west side?
He probably will be.
See.
Number 59, too, looks like out there.
59 would be Ethan Royal.
All right. And number 76.
Caleb Miller.
There we go.
Center forgot to bring the ball out to the field.
Yeah. So that's who's out there for your Pirates JV team right now. And number 31, that's Frazier. Down
Frazier.
Goes Frazier.
Down goes Frazier. Quarterback's in the shotgun from
he's
the
gonna roll
30.
Out. And, ooh.
He's like, I don't want to get
Miller
hit.
Miller kid was coming down on him pretty hard there. He's second down and 10.
Glover getting coached up.
If you want to be my Glover, you have got to be friend. Second down and 10 at the 30-yard line. No play on that one. Incomplete pass.
That's a big boy, number 75. Is he a sophomore?
75. That's Bricky. That's the Bricky kid.
Is that the Bricky kid?
Yeah.
How old is he?
I think he's a sophomore.
Yeah.
Or no, it's 58, Bricky. No, right. 75 just came in. We don't have him out there.
75?
Yep. Let's get his name out there.
Brody Scott.
Oh, Brody Scott. Blaine's brother.
Blaine's brother.
Yeah, Brody Scott. And
all right.
Brody Scott at the defensive end position. And he going to blast through. And Caleb Arthur
Caleb
is going to go.
Caleb Arthur, holy cow. That wasn't even fair.
Yeah, outside linebacker came.
Caleb Arthur.
Nobody blocked him.
Hey, listen, if I'm blocking one kid out there, it's Caleb Arthur.
Yeah.
He's pretty good.
Well, I don't think they have a scouting report on anybody. Third down and 20 now.
Third and 20 from the 20.
See if we can get some updates from scrimmages.
Oh, here we go. It's somebody new. Number 8.
It's Brumfield, I think.
No, Brumfield's 9.
Oh, okay.
8 is Eli Jones.
So Eli Jones out there. Slot eye left. Counter. Give the number 26 up there. Not very much yards, but a couple yards.
Oh, man. He's not happy.
Maxwell. Beautiful.
Well, he liked what he's doing, I think.
Oh, he did like it. I thought he was mad that he didn't kick him out, but I guess he did.
Waverly's struggling with Warren, 42 to nothing.
They're winning?
Yeah.
Well, they got that kid, you know, they're supposed to be all everything.
I think they got a decent offense, I'd say so, right?
Yeah.
Unless Warren just really is that bad.
Well, yeah.
We don't know. And Waverly must have traded this one like the Super Bowl.
Hell yeah.
Showed all the cards.
Lattimore,
Lattimore, you gotta be a sophomore on that one, bud.
Nope, gotta get the ball. Don't let it drop.
West now takes the lead, 24-21. That's a nail biter there, next.
Yeah, that'd be good for them. I figured. I don't know what Portsmouth will have this year. You know,
you got a tough gate right out of the barn there. Ironton comes to play.
Is that Wilson, who they start with?
Yeah, Wilson 18, Zane Trace 0 in their scrum. See, get an update on Jackson and Ironton here. Good scrimmage. You got some competitive rest.
Lightning.
Let's see here. Was a lightning delay, so.
9:06 to go. Wheelersburg up 21-3. So we're going to have a bunch of new players, I have a feeling.
Yeah, this is going to be the sophomore class for the junior class. So if you can get some names out there. Looks like Glover out there, number 8.
Who's the quarterback?
That's going to be you just had him on the corner. And they're going to give it to nobody. Eli Jones fumbled the football. And
Eli Jones, the quarterback, fumbled the ball. And Taze Valley recovers.
Well, that was going to be a jet sweep to Eric Lattimore. Yeah. And Eric got there a little bit too much quick for him, I think. Turnover on downs. I mean, on the fumble there. Ball at the 30-yard line. 9:02 to go, 21-3, Wittesburg leading this scrimmage. Ball at the 31-yard line.
9 minutes to go, fourth quarter. We're seeing the JV, I guess you could say, going to play this quarter.
Yeah, JV's going to finish up. And next week we'll start the regular season, and Lord willing, we'll get through all of them. Number 76 is...
Just decide, maybe I'll go.
Yeah, 70. Taze Valley's got that Notre Dame look, don't they?
He's
got the gold pants and the dark blue jersey.
Yep. They're not in a hurry to do much of anything, though.
No. Slot eye for Taze Valley. Turn and get to the guy through. Caleb Barger makes him cut back in, and he's all the way down to the 18-yard line as far. Finally, Eric Lattimore lays him down. But not before they get a first down on that one. Hill, 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 huddle right here.
What the ref's looking at. They haven't ran the daggone play clock the whole game.
I guess they're just going through the motions.
Yep, I'm sure.
Yeah.
It's their practice game, too.
Got a bend, don't break defense there. What they're talking about.
Yeah, I mean, Taze Valley's had their chances.
Got a couple players over there for Wheelersburg with their helmets off. That's a no-no.
Well, maybe not in a scrimmage.
Yeah, maybe not. Hand off here.
Nice tackle. Glover.
Glover, and also on the number 76, Miller.
Miller, yep.
Good job by both of those sophomores. Sophomore class is pretty talented.
Yep.
And number 59, Royal, coming in.
Who is 88? That's another new number. Let's see here. Caden Johnson, sophomore.
Caden Johnson, huh?
That's what it says, 88.
All right, slot eye. It's going to be a rollout, number 13. Got his guy out in the flat, catches it. And he's out of bounds, but not before he gets first down. Ball at the 10-yard line.
Not sure who was in coverage. Ed Wilson and Drake out there, and neither one of them covered him.
Well, that's a linebacker coverage there. The guy came out of the backfield. So.
Yep. They'll be first and goal from the 5.
Slot eye right for Taze Valley. It's an isolation right, and that's going to get stood up, but he does pick up 3 or 4 yards.
It's down to the two.
Good run second by that goal. Kid right there.
Yep. Uh-oh.
Second down and three to go, goal line. And they're yelling at Brody to get in there, and number 8 to come out.
Yep.
Caden Johnson. Oh, yeah, Caden Johnson. He's from Southwestern. Is big he? Big kid, yeah. Sophomore.
Most of these kids are sophomores.
A lot of sophomores. A lot of freshmen and sophomores. They got, I believe, 46 freshmen and sophomores.
That's great.
Yeah. Oh. Handoff.
Oh.
Got a false start here. Oh, encroachment by the Pirates. That'll be half the distance to the goal line.
Well,
Coach is saying we got to figure out how to space these guys. I'm telling you, man. I mean, look at Wheelersburg. It's just natural to.
You think they're talking about the sideline or the,
no, the kids.
Defensive line?
I think they're talking about the kids over here.
They had chairs and they did really good at the beginning of the game.
They did.
And it's sort of gone back to the way it always is.
6 minutes ago.
Here we go. Hand up the middle. Oh,
oh, missing touchdown.
We had every gap filled except the one they ran in.
Yeah, well, that's the one that we had to have.
Yeah.
So the JV scores on the JV. For Taze Valley, it's 21-10. If the extra point goes.
They didn't let the girl kick it. Nope. Oh, she's going to kick off. That's what they're going to do. Kick is up. And good. 21-10.
I do. Here is. We will get a live sound bite from our atmosphere tonight.
Yeah.
Yeah. Bob Willard said, it sounds like a baseball game there. He said, we might not even have to have a ear pad without the headphones with it. No crowd.
They're not going to let her kick.
They're going to let her kick here. It'll be 30-yard line. Williamsburg JV team will come out again, try to
get an
answer,
offensive play.
Trying to answer here.
That's right. So we got 6:11 to go, fourth quarter, 21-10 Williamsburg. People trying to figure out who's in what and where.
Yeah, trying to figure out who goes where and add some guys out there. I believe we've called everybody's name, but
we've tried.
We'll see if there's anybody out there that we don't see. Number 60, I have not called his number.
61?
Just 60, regular 60. I think he's our JV center.
Zach Mays.
Mays.
Yep.
Webster. All right, here comes the handoff to Lattimore, and he will cut it up, and he'll pick up 3 or 4 yards.
Yep. Eric.
Yes. Second down. That's the play they wanted to run when they fumbled it. Second down and 6, so they did get positive green there. Number 66. Who's number 66?
Drew Holsinger.
Oh, so it's not Mays. It's 66. All right. Xavier Stanley goes. And it's a give to Glover. Cuts it up.
Ooh.
If you want to be my Glover, puts it up to the 39.
Glover likes to just, he likes contact.
He is up in there. He's
he
not afraid.
Like, hey, I'm going to lower my shoulder and go straight. Third and one. That's a nice looking play. Line did a good job there. Ooh, the kid with the blue pants is in the game. He didn't make it in.
Oh, good for him.
I didn't think he would.
I thought they were going to run him after this.
I did too. I thought they were going to make him do up downs.
Eli Jones in the quarterback position.
Telling Glover where to go.
Yep. Quarterback is going to keep Eli Jones. And he may go all the way.
Uh-oh.
And he may go all the way. And he does go all the way.
Jones, 60 yards.
Eli Jones is a somebody put me in the quarterback mix.
Yeah.
Huh? You forgot one.
It was a nice hold by our tackle. Hold.
Yeah.
That did turn the kid around, and they didn't call it. He had him bear hugged.
Well, it's JV.
I know.
They hold a lot.
Willisburg answers. 4:55 to go. 27-10.
Eli Jones with the touchdown. 27-10. So
hey,
one
good speed.
Yeah, he is fast. He's got good speed on him. He's one of those sophomores.
So let's see. Boomstick still in there to kick.
Yep.
There goes Chad Johnson out of the press box.
Chad Johnson's going to go down and suit up.
Yep. He's going to tackle the Viking in the end zone. The mascot's here.
Coach
Nate Dogg's trying to get Nate Dogg in the game.
Nate Dogg has never been on the camera yet.
No.
He's on here tonight.
He's going to find out tonight.
Yeah. So Willisburg answers the bell with the JV versus the JV here.
Yep. 28-10, 4:55 to go. You know, that's a good job by the JV there.
Yeah.
Nice blocking. Glover looked good running the ball.
He did.
Eric Lattimore,
All three sophomores.
Yep.
So you've got to think.
Future is bright.
Ooh, that sophomore class looks pretty good.
Yes, they do.
They're going to be seeing a lot of action next year.
Oh, yeah.
Because the junior class is very thin, not very deep.
They've
got about 10 kids.
Okay.
And there's not a lineman in there, I don't think.
Well, there are plenty of linemen in that sophomore class.
Sophomore, yeah.
Well, here we go. Pays Valley from the 30. It's a pitch. Caleb Arthur.
Missed that one.
Misses him. Drake misses him. I don't know who
number 15
is.
The
last one. And he misses
him. Come, Eric.
Here comes Eric Lattimore.
Can he save it?
To beat.
Eric Lattimore with the play of the game.
Oh, my goodness.
Good for Eric.
Who's number 15? That's a new number.
I think it's Bo Castaneda.
It is Bo Castaneda. How do you know this?
Because I know the kids, because they're a year ahead of Jackson.
So okay.
I know some of
those. Any of these kids.
Well, Bo Castaneda, he's actually been in a couple of Days of Our Lives episodes.
Okay. I didn't know you were a Days of Our Lives kind of guy.
He was. They kind of pulled him from the daytime enemy winning series there to come up here. He knows Stefan.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that was a good run by him.
That was.
Kid from Taze Valley.
Sure was. He just ran out of gas.
About a 60-yard run.
Yep.
And it's a
road to the ref with one leg.
Yeah.
He can't get out of the way. Knocks his hat off.
They were going for pay dirt on that one.
Yeah. Caleb Arthur's like, you're not going to get around me this time, buddy. Uh-oh. 62 is a rough pair of pants there.
He does. They're
ripped on both sides.
These poor guys need some equipment.
Listen, if they can afford a field house, they can afford
a
pair of pants.
Now, this could be their practice stuff.
4:10 to go.
I'm assuming that's what this is.
28-10. Yep.
And Taze Valley has done what Wheelersburg. They've really not shown anything.
No.
Just some basic stuff. And here is the handoff to number, this time, 52.
Let him up. Who's 52?
52. Come on now.
Come on, whoever you are.
Get a boy on it. Number 75 in there, too. Get his name.
That's Blaine Scott's brother.
75.
Brody Scott.
Brody,
75.
52.
52. Jake Saltzman.
Need Jake Saltzman to step up on that one.
Yeah. He could be Jake from the state of Ohio.
Yeah, there you go.
Jake from the state
of
Kentucky.
Yeah.
Caskey running down the stairs.
You, dude.
Like it's his job.
All right.
There's Eddie Miller.
And he will get in the JV quarter running back. Answers the call for it.
Well, that makes it 28-16 with 3:29 to go. Well, the girl don't get to kick again.
Hey, back up, back up.
Nice drive by the Hayes Valley Vikings. Kick is up and good. Makes it 28-17 with 3:28 to go. I'd expect an onside kick.
Well, they're not kicking anymore, but it could be still onside.
Yeah. Well, they're probably spotting it at the 30, so it's going to be tough to get the ball.
This is going to be like a blowout game, a high-scoring game by the end of the – if the JVs can't pick up the defense a little bit.
How'd you like to be that kid? He's got to go chase the ball when they kick it every time.
Yeah.
One of their own players. You should have some little kid running back there to get it.
That should be the ball boy.
Yeah.
But you can't have anybody here.
Yeah, we got ball boys.
Oh, we do?
I think usually it's Coach Woodward's son and Bryson Williams, Coach Williams' son. I don't know if they're here.
Eli Jones comes out for the Pirates.
Hey, they should run a play quick. They don't have any defense out there.
No, that's why I snap it right now.
Yeah. So you got Drake at a receiver, Lattimore a receiver, and not sure. Glover's in the backfield with Eli Jones.
Oh.
Here comes the jet sweep.
Oh,
and it goes Glover. Nowhere.
Looks like they were a little confused on that because we had almost two guys going on motion on that one. So. Yeah.
Casey Doerr's the other receiver.
Second down and nine. Max your axe. That's what he called him. He's the axe. I think they just cut him off the team. That's what they did. Put him out. You're out.
Yep, see, here he is. Come out in blue pants.
The only one kid with blue pants.
Yep. Here we go, 2:55 to go.
Crazy. Hand off to Lattimore. Lattimore will cut it up, and he'll get 3-4 yards.
Yeah.
Big Ashy coming in. Number 64 for the Pirates. Big Ashy.
Big Ashy. Is that really his name?
Yeah, his name's Ashy. I don't know if we could call him Big Ashy. But
probably not.
He's a solid kid, though.
Yeah.
I mean, he's a good-sized boy. His dad was pretty solid, but he's not like him. That kid's a big dude.
78's a big boy, too.
Yep.
So, third and six.
Third and six, I think.
Ball at the old Wheelersburg 34-yard line. Door in motion. And Doerr
cuts it up. And first down.
Nice run by Casey Doerr.
Yep. That's that zone stretch where they just find a seam and hop up in it.
Yep.
So 2 minutes to go here.
Stopping the clock to move the chains. Coach is not happy.
He's madder than he's ever been.
Yep. Wheelersburg twins to the right. Single back, Glover.
Mm-hmm.
Gonna throw
Jones
it.
Gonna throw it, and he throws it.
Uh-oh. He's
holy
got
cow.
Oh, Lattimore.
Lattimore, wow.
Lattimore. Nice throw by Eli Jones. Yeah. I mean, hit him right in stride.
Well, I mean, you can hit him in stride throwing it from the end zone. Golly, he got it.
Lattimore
ball
can fly.
Eric Lattimore with a
wow
bomb pass makes it 34-17. Oh, wow.
Nice job by Eli Jones and Lattimore.
Just throw them up, everybody.
Listen, no one's covering Lattimore out there for the JV Tays Valley Vikings. I promise you. If they want to throw it, they could just throw it to Lattimore day long, and no one's catching him.
I mean, that was some serious speed running through there.
He caught it at the 20 and still beat the kid by 10 yards.
He overthrew that by 10 yards, and he caught it. Football.
Yeah, you're missing something. Oh, you got –
the good thing about it.
Oh, look.
Oh, here we go.
There goes Man Bear Pig out there for the
JV. He wanted it.
Look at
he
him.
Wants it.
Well, Kenny's going to go out there. Kenny's and they're not blocking anybody.
Yeah, I don't understand it. But I guess you got to work on it.
I guess.
Boomstick getting a nice workout tonight. He kicks it up. And
Boomstick, good. See, look, we got a ball boy.
That's true. Good point.
I think that is Coach Woodward's son.
Could be.
Either that or it's Carson, Coach Williams' son.
Well, our JV defenses for both teams have been a little bit
suspect.
A little bit suspect on some things.
But the offense
has been really good for both teams.
It looked really good.
It's a half glass, half full, you know, half empty,
hey,
half
listen,
full.
Listen, if you can put up a touchdown every time you go out there, don't matter how bad your defense is.
It's true.
Well, this is the last scrimmage here, and they all start. I would like to tell you that they start counting next week, but they don't. Wheelersburg could go 0-6 and still make the playoffs. So
that's right.
The streak continues this year no matter what.
That's right.
Bless you. Braden Wilson out there for number one out there. And Lattimore on the corner. Yep. Lattimore is the player of the game. Eric, not Derek.
Run up the middle. Oh
nice play.
Tackle. Who was that?
That was number...
That was Wilson. Braden Wilson.
Braden Wilson, number one in our hearts.
That's right.
So, yeah, we're going to give the player of the game to Eric Lattimore for the touchdown-saving tackle, even though they did still scored. But
yeah, but he hustled 60 yards down the field.
And then he receiving of a 30-yard bomb from Eli Jones. Eli Jones probably could be also in that mix for player
of the game.
Two touchdowns on the throw. And so we're going to give it to two sophomores, players of the game. You win a player of the game award verbal announcement from Burfitt.
Or if you can go to Deemer's.
You go to Deemer's, which doesn't exist anymore, but they may give you some chicken.
Drake with the breakup.
40 seconds to go, third down and 6. Guys, we do not know if Berg fan will be invited to any of these games.
Probably not one place.
We don't know. We're not sure.
You know the...
Yeah, we're sure where we're going to be allowed to go.
We'll
just
to
be because of
can.
The restrictions. I'm assuming we can go, but we don't know yet.
There'll be a phone call to, obviously, the AD.
The good thing is we can go remote, so we don't have to be in a press box, and that may help us.
Zone.
We can be in the end zone, so that, I think we'll be okay. But regardless, we hope you guys are able to listen and watch. There are going to be some Facebook live streams there for these guys. It's not what we want, but at least these kids are getting out there to playing and having a season. It's probably be the last game play of the game. It's picked off by
Lattimore!
Eric Lattimore. Well, Eric Lattimore wins the award for player of the game after he
pick six, a 40-yard touchdown reception, and a game save or a touchdown saving tackle.
Yeah, we got to give it to him. Yeah. Eli Jones was tied.
Yeah, but that just that, sorry, Eli.
Sorry, Eli. Yeah.
Both fans from Taze Valley are now leaving.
Yeah. So, got word, the confirmation that Shaw will allow us to be somewhere that we can hide.
At home,
so that's good.
Just got to get somewhere on the road.
Yeah, so.
We'll do the best we can, and
and
we'll get there somehow. We have to climb a fence.
Yeah, we'll do something. Holsinger's dad was digging underneath the turf getting in here. He wouldn't want to be denied.
Nope.
And the kick is up, and it is just inside of the
If you're Taze Valley, are you trying to throw another pass here?
No, you can't stop working on what you want to work on. They didn't know that Eric Lattimore was that good on the cornerback.
Look, they got the number one DN. Number 31's going back out there.
He's going to run the football. Number 9's going to go.
The Green Hornet's coming out.
Quarterback.
No way.
Yeah.
They're not going to let the Green Hornet quarterback.
They may. Score's 42-17. The varsity score was, I think, 21-3.
21-3, yep.
21-3. And
JV's put up three scores.
JV's made it interesting in this game. Wheelersburg had some trouble blocking the outside defensive ends of
Taze Valley,
but had some good pass blocking, and they ran the ball well up the middle. So they'll good coaching points. And this time it's caught. Green Hornet gets thrown down.
Green Hornet got a pass.
Good catch. He's got to be a freshman. He ain't bigger than a minute, man.
I don't know, but 23 seconds to go.
Yep.
All the fans have filed out.
Yeah.
Both of them.
Yep. Parking lot's empty.
Yeah. Well, not yet. You got fans in both end zones with parents watching from the fence. Here we go. This
second down and two to go?
Second and two. Ball at the 38-yard line of Taze Valley. Yeah. What's up, buddy?
Rollout pass by number 13. He's going to hit the guy coming out of the backfield, number 10. Good defense, but first down.
And that probably will end the play game. And they're going to let them snap one more.
Probably got one more snap.
They're going to run the clock.
He just said, come on, meow, meow. They ain't getting this in.
Yeah.
They're going to there's no way you're getting this off. That's your ball game.
That's your ball game, guys. Wheelersburg will take on Chillicothe up at Chillicothe next week. We will try to give you as much information as you can. Hopefully there is a live stream there. I'm sure Chillicothe will do that. That's it. Any final thoughts here, Jason?
Hey, good showing by both teams. You know, it was a good scrimmage. I think they both, you know, got things to work on. And it was good to hit somebody else, I'm sure, for those kids.
Yes, and that's the problem. They can't shake hands, guys. It's a wave.
Yeah, they're all waving. That's what we do in softball. We just wave at them.
Yeah, they give the old nod.
Hey!
All right, well, that's Mean Gene and Jay Smith signing off. Next week, the Duke of Earl will probably be up at Chillicothe. I don't know who he will have, but if he's not, then I'll be there. Or Jason, one of us will be up there podcasting for you guys. Thanks. Peace out.